What's up, people? In this video, I'm going to show you guys how I made this amazing art here. Let's go. So I've been planning on making this video for a very long time now, but I've never gotten the chance to because I've been dead as busy. So here we go. This is a full-time tutorial on how to draw outlines and paint. Yep, that's it. So I'm using this guy's photo here for this work. Yeah, so I'm just gonna import the picture and resize and other stuff, then crop the canvas to like just merge it around, just get it fit together, you know what I mean. After that is done, I'm going to create a new layer, a layer above it. First, increase the opacity of the picture. I'm going to create a layer above it. So, I'll choose this. So right now, this work I've actually done, I've done it before, so I'm just voicing it over. So you don't expect me to get it exact. I'm just explaining through as the work is going. So I'm explaining what I'm doing. So basically, this is just the outline process. I use a technical pen for my outline here because that's how I use my outline. I use the technical pen. I love using brushes with that sharp tips, with the pointy tips. Yeah, I love using brushes like that. So when you're drawing outlines like this, you I already try to connect each edge together. That is, there's no space. I always start with the outer part of the picture. That's what I do first. My outline, I draw the outer part of the picture first. Don't be scared. This video is not gonna be a long video because I'm gonna make some parts on time lapse. It's actually a long video though because it's like 45 minutes I think. But I'm gonna put some parts on time lapse. Okay. So do I do my eyebrows? I'll still use the technical pen to sketch out the eyebrows like the way you just saw it. So for my eyes, I usually draw the corner of the eyes longer, like the anime kind of eyes, but I'm not connect the under the eyes. The nose, you see what I got the nose. This is kind of too fast for me, so I can't really just explain everything in details. So you can just watch the way I'm sketching out these details. For the beards, I sketch out each string of the beards. For when the beard is scanty, but if it's a full kind of beard, I might just sketch out only the corner of the beard and just use a color fill to just fill up the rest of it. So then now I'm done with the whole outline process and this guy has tattoos. So I created a new layer for the tattoos. So I'm going to start tracing the tattoos too. I'm going to start tracing the tattoo from here, and tattoos are kind of complicated sometimes because you might not really even be seeing what you are drawing. Like right now, I don't know what I'm drawing here, but I'm just drawing it anyways. There was a time where I drew a whole tattoo and I didn't even know what I drew on the tattoo till like a couple of weeks later when I came back and saw the picture. Then I kind of found that like, wow, so this is how I drew a boat on this tattoo and I never knew. So I'm just tracing directly what I think I'm seeing on the picture. It doesn't have to be exact, just trace whatever you're seeing, you think you're seeing on the picture. Then whatever you get, you can just leave it anyways like that. That's how I draw tattoos. So once I'm done tracing the whole tattoo, I usually reduce the opacity of the tattoo layer by tapping on two fingers in layer and sliding down. That's if you're using Procreate. If you're using any other app, you can find out how to do that, how to reduce the opacity. So now I've done the tattoos. And I'm just fading off this one a little bit here. Because that's actually how it looks like on the picture. I made the tattoo layers together with the outline layer. I'm going to add up a reference as usual. I always add up a reference of the picture. It makes your work a whole lot easier instead of going back and forth trying to pick up a skin color. Alright, so we are into the part of making the color now. So I'm going to go into my outline layer and right select to automatic, select the background of the picture, that's the outer part. Am I too fast? Select the outer part of the picture. Then I'm going to free hand and invert it. Yeah. So they are going to pick up a skin color. I'm not picking up the color from the skin. You see, I'm trying to customize the color. I'm going to match this guy's tone here. So just keep trying out colors that till it matches the tone you want. Just so your color looks beautiful, and I'm satisfied with this color I just made. It looks kind of attractive. It's attractive. It's not too brown and it's not too light. It's just perfect for me. So now I'm making the other flat colors, the cap. I'm just trying to make the cap look alright. I don't really have to explain much of what I'm doing here because I'm just filling in the flat colors, the eyes, the teeth, just the teeth, then the sleeves and all that stuff. I'm just filling the flat colors, no much explanation. That's what I'm doing. I think someone complained about my work one time, like, why do I always give everyone pink lips? Even if you don't have pink lips, I always give them pink lips on my art. I think that's just my own style. That's my own style of drawing. I give everyone pink lips. Just makes it beautiful for me. Alright, so I'm done with the flat colors. So now I'm heading to this complicated stuff that gets a lot of people confused and quit on the job, which is the shading. So, do you guys see what I just did? Because I didn't even see what I just did yet, man. I think... Alright, hold up, I actually picked up a skin color. It's the skin color, not the original skin color, the base color which I made before, then made it kind of darker. I hope you also, if you didn't see that, you can just take it back a little bit and watch it again. Sorry, I wasn't really paying attention. So, what I'm trying to do here is just to trace the shading of the picture. I'm trying to trace the shading of the picture. So right now, I'm looking at the dark part of the picture. As you can see, these parts are... This is so complicated. I don't know how to break this down in this video. I'm just tracing out the darker part of the picture. Hold on, I'm going to show you guys. Yeah, you can see I just did here. I use the lines to trace out the darker edges of the picture. Then just dropped in the color there. I have a video where I kind of explain this improperly. I explained this properly in the previous video. I think, yeah. I'll leave that in the description. It's a really long video, I didn't make that short, so this I'm just trying to explain and show you guys what I'm doing. So I'm tracing to the darker edges of the picture. So right now you can see on the eyes there, right around the eyes, that area is dark. So also, so what I'm basically doing here is just tracing on everywhere that is not the base color. Everything I see to be a shading, that's what I'm trying to trace out here. Everything I see to be a shading, that's what I'm trying to trace out. So if you notice now, after making the vector trace, I use an eraser, which is a soft airbrush, to fade out some parts of the shading. That's how I do my shading. I do vector and it's kind of smooth shade mixed together. After shading the vector, then I make a smooth shade out of it. I'm not just randomly putting the smooth shade, like for example, I'm going to do under the neck now. After making this shade, this vector shade of under the neck, I'm going to fade it out. You can see how I just did that just now. So that's just the concept. Also adding back in some shadings too on it. So I use a soft airbrush to add some shading on the nose there. Yeah, I'm shading on the nose. Because I can try to see that on the reference. I don't have to trace that. I'm seeing that on the reference. That's why I did that. So on the usual case, I'm a really confused artist, so don't mind me. I usually change my style of painting randomly. Sometimes I use red to make that effect on the nose, like it's a blood kind of thing on the nose, and sometimes I don't. Sometimes I paint with multiply, sorry, sometimes I shade with multiply, sometimes I don't. So don't mind me. I just have different styles of drawing. So we are onto a different layer of shading again, which is darker, the next darker shade. Like you saw me do before, I created a new layer for this, then I'm just testing it out. I'm just testing out the color. So I picked up the previous shade color, then made it darker. I'm kind of confused here because I don't even know if the color looks okay. But anyways, I'm gonna go with it to see if it's fine. So, all right, so my reason is gonna do is I'm just trying to create the shading from a darker shade from the original picture and fading off that part of the shade, because that's how it looks like a picture in the original picture. So I use the soft airbrush and a technical pen for my whole painting and shading. So then I'm just going, what am I doing? Alright, I'm adding more dark shades on the beards, in the areas of the beards, and added the dark shade under the lips, then under the neck too as usual. I faded that off. So I'm just adding some dark shades, more dark shades on the shoulders. After watching this video, please you can leave a comment if you are an artist on how you do your painting style, because I know that there are different patterns of paint. Some people do start their painting from the darkest shade to the lightest shade, then before they make up the skin color. For me I usually start off my painting using a base color first, then create the lighter shade to the darker shade. Just leave in the comment section how you prefer to paint and why you prefer painting that way. So back to the video, I'm painting the lips right now. I actually picked up the lip color from the painting I made before. I made it darker. Then I'm just trying to make the painting looking at the reference. Also, I'm going to do the same for the top lip too. Then for the gum, for his gum, I used the same color of the lip to paint the gum too. So it's time to do the highlights on the face. If you don't know highlights, our highlights are the light shadings on the on the picture. So for my highlight, I created a new layer above it, picking up the base color. Then I'm going to make it lighter, upwards diagonally to the left this time around. Then I'm going to use the technical pen first to add the major highlights, which is always on the middle of the nose. Then I'm going to add a little bit of highlight there. I'll do some highlights too on his lips using the technical pen. I'm also going to use a soft airbrush to do some highlights on the face too. But for now, I'll just start with the technical pen, adding those highlights first. So now I'm using the same color for the eyes on the nose. Then I'm creating a new layer this time around. The fuck am I doing? Okay, I forgot what this is called, but I watched a video where an artist explained what I'm trying to do here. It's kind of like a bounce effect, a light bounce effect you add to a picture you draw. So I'm adding this bounce effect now on the corner of his face. That stuff actually makes your art look amazing in a very surprising way. Just adding this bounce effect. You usually add the bounce effect on the dark part of the picture, on the dark corner of the picture. When you add this bounce effect there, you also have to calculate how the structure of the face, you know, making this bounce effect, so that the light you're adding won't make the face look different. I'm just following this usual face structure and adding this bounce effect on the face. So I use the kind of blue light. I'm adding a blue light on his face. Yeah. So that's what it is, this bounce effect. I'm going to add this on the neck and on the shoulder too, just to make it look like it's an extra light coming to the picture. That's just the thing about art. The more like your light source and your light in the picture is actually what beautifies your work. So you have to have a good sense of lighting. Choose the right colors too. So right now I'm going to do the soft airbrush stuff on the face. Highlights using the soft airbrush. That's what I'm trying to fade off here now on his cheeks. About that. So at this point, I'm going to add in a darker shade again, because I'm not satisfied with dark shades there. I'm creating a new layer for this. So I'm going to pick up the dark shade there and make it darker diagonally to the. You're going to make it darker. Then using the soft airbrush, I'm just going to make that dark shade on, like underneath the cap there, because that area of the picture is much darker than the others I did. So usually, like I said, I do change my art style sometimes. Like usually I usually have only two layers of dark shades, but for this picture I'm using three layers of dark shade, because there's an extra dark point in this picture. There's an extra dark shade in this picture. That's how I created a new layer for this. So where we are now, if you notice, I don't know if you notice, I use a dark shade to shade around the beard, the region of the beard, just to create that dark kind of realism on his beards. Alright, so I'm just adding some highlights on his eyes, some lights on his eyes. I use a softer brush to shade in a bright kind of brown on his eyes, just for the effect. More beauty, I'm just adding beauty to this work right now. So I'm adding more bounce effect on the cap. You can see there isn't really a bounce effect on the cap in the original picture, but in my own art I added those effects there. So while drawing these things, you don't really have to follow exactly what I see in the picture, because you can never draw a picture exact. Because for example, the nose, how are you supposed to draw a nose exactly like how it's actually in the picture? That's not possible. So sometimes you have to do some imaginative stuff. So for the chain now, I'm using a brush, which is the luminance brush light pen, for the glow effect on the chains. I feel so thirsty. Now I'm going to make the teeth, add some lighting on the teeth. So that's actually that for this picture. Well, I'm done with the whole shading and painting. So this is the thing I don't like doing picture, making a background. It just gets me really confused trying to design the background. If you have ideas on background, you can leave that on the comment section too, on how you feel about making backgrounds. Is it the best part of the picture for you, or it actually frustrates you just the same way it frustrates me too? So you can actually leave a comment on what you like best while you're drawing, like what's your best part of drawing. For me, I prefer, my best part of drawing is the part of making the outlines, because that's really easy. So I do enjoy painting, but I mostly enjoy doing outlines. Yeah, so that's it. I guess that's that about this video. If you like this video, destroy the like button and subscribe, because I'll be posting a lot of cool stuff for you guys. Just keep in touch, and that's that for this video. Bye.